Welcome, welcome. Two hotheads where activism happens. You know who it is. It's Mike Cann. Big week this week. And fortunately, Heather Mack's not able to make it in. She's had a moving crisis. Today's moving day in Boston for everybody who's a student. And she's not a student, but she is moving right now. And basically what happened to her yesterday is that she had planned to make the move yesterday and last night. And when she went into the new apartment, the old people still hadn't moved out. And she's under a deadline to get everything out of her old apartment today. So she's kind of stuck in a bind. We hope she gets it all worked out and gets moved in. And we might even hear from her later. We'll see. But our telephone number is 617-606-4122. It's been a huge couple of weeks just in terms of politics and activism locally, nationally. We're going to get into it all today. Ron Paul, the Republican National Convention, the Democratic National Convention coming up this week. Just so much going on over the next couple of weeks. And you know, Ron Paul is... Out of the Republican race, but a lot of interesting news and speculation about what might happen next. Gary Johnson's put out a big video about how he's what he calls himself a Ron Paul revolutionary. You can see it on my Mike Cann YouTube as well as Gary Johnson YouTube. And basically, you can see he's definitely playing to the Ron Paul crowd. He spoke at the Ron Paul Fest during the RNC. He hung out all through the convention. Gary Johnson did, Governor Gary Johnson, Libertarian nominee for president. So you have to think that he is wooing Ron Paul right now. And Ron Paul's scheduled this week to be on the Jay Leno show. And there's a lot of speculation that he's going to have some big news. It's actually been said that there will be some big news on the Jay Leno show with Ron Paul this week. So the question I have for everyone, call in and weigh in. Hopefully some of the folks in the studio will have an opinion on it as well. What's the big news going to be? Is Ron Paul going to run a third party, which some people hope and speculate, which I think, unfortunately, is not going to happen? Or will he actually endorse Gary Johnson, campaign for him? Maybe he'll be the Treasury Secretary under a Gary Johnson administration. What do you think is going to happen? What is the big news? That's the first question that we're going to throw out there. 617-606-4122 for people listening. We're also going to talk to... in the show today, we're going to talk to Casey Hoy. She's doing a walk. We've featured her on the show. She's walking from Boston to D.C. She's already left. She left earlier this week. Some folks from Unregular Radio met up with her and walked her off, I guess is the term. Is that what we say? Walked her off? Yeah, well, you were there, right, Dar?
I was there. I had breakfast with her over in JP.
What was that, Tuesday, Wednesday?
Wednesday.
So JP was the start of it, or Boston Common?
No, she went to Boston Common. She started from Dewey, I believe.
Okay.
All the Commons, one of the
and
other.
And then went to Dewey, sure. Yeah. So Boston was the start of it, and she's walking to D.C. We're going to find out how she's doing. Again, you know, follow up on her, why she is doing this, and the website is whywalkabout.com. Very exciting. Casey's someone that's helped us out on our show quite a bit. And the station we love on Regular Radio, so we're very excited about her activism and talk to her today in Providence. I know everyone wants to find out how she's doing. Seen some pictures on Facebook, and she's resting right now today apparently. But she's already I think feeling it. I mean, a walk to Providence. I'm just very excited that she made it that far. I mean, even if she doesn't make it all the way to D.C.
She will.
But I think she will. I think she might be the one that's crazy enough to actually make it. Yeah, Derek, you know, right?
Oh, yeah. She's dedicated like a motherfucker.
Yeah. And I don't mean crazy in a bad way. Sometimes crazy is good. Crazy in a good way. So we're very excited. And 2 weeks away. What's 2 weeks away? Does everyone know?
2 weeks away.
Spencer, you're here. What's 2 weeks away?
The Boston Freedom Rally.
Yeah. Do you have any applause for that? That's like, this is the big event every year. The one that I'm always at, no matter what. I don't think I'm ever going to miss this. I don't care. I don't care what kind of work trip I have to, you know, they try to send me on. I've missed things like Global Marijuana Marches and things like that because of work and work trips. But the Boston Freedom Rally, it's the must-go-to event in Boston and nationally. It's the second biggest marijuana reform festival in the country, the biggest on the East Coast. I was a long-time person who booked a lot of the music and some of the acts. Some of the speakers, and I'm very excited about this year's lineup, especially the speakers that we have. I'm speaking, I think everybody knows that by now since I'm such a promo whore, but Saturday, September 15th, 2 weeks from now, we're going to do a big feature on the Freedom Rally next week. And Unregular Radio, if you're not able to get to the Boston Freedom Rally, know that Unregular Radio will be broadcasting from the main stage all day at the Freedom Rally live. You can listen to it live. You can hear all the speeches. If I'm on the main stage, you'll hear me. If I'm on the Stingray stage, you might have to catch it on YouTube later. But you'll get the full day of the main stage live on Unregular Radio, which it always sounds so good. They do such a good job on the professional broadcast that they put out on this day. So it's very exciting. I cannot wait. You know, we'll go over much more about the Freedom Rally, but 2 weeks from today. And then 3 weeks from today, we're also taking part in Audit the Fed, which is going on, starting the same place. It's going to start at Parkman Bandstand. So there's a lot of events, there's a lot of news, a lot of activity all around Unregular Radio, around Boston and nationally. We haven't even gotten to much of the national news beyond Ron Paul and Gary Johnson, but very exciting. Another candidate for president that we support and follow and promote is Jill Stein. Jill Stein's actually up in Portland, Maine today. It's the Canna Fest. This is the first annual event that Charlie Wynot is putting on up in Portland, Maine. And I know State Rep Diane Russell, who's also a friend of the show, who's been on the show many times. She's going to be speaking there with Jill Stein. So if you're in Maine, you should be there right now. You shouldn't even waste a minute because you're going to miss it. It's already halfway over. So get there. Check it out. Look it up on Facebook. Our phone number is 617-606-4122. We're going to play some music. We're going to come back, and we're going to talk more about politics, activism, the things that we do on the show. Yeah. And what kind of music do we have?
We have Audible Mainframe with Radioland
coming
up, and then a little Muse with Uprising.
Yeah. We're live to Hotheads, where activism happens, and that was Muse, the Uprising. And before that, we heard some Audible Mainframe. What was that, the radio song? Radio, what was it?
Radioland.
Radioland. I love that song. Rest in Peace Expo, a good friend of mine. We lost this year, another big loss last few weeks and last year. It's, you know, a lot of good things have happened and a lot of bad things. And losing Expo was one of the tough things for myself personally and a lot of people out there. He's an activist, a great performer, and we'll always play his music on this show. Two Hotheads, where activism happens. Our phone number is 617-606-4122. We were just talking about the Republican National Convention and Ron Paul and Gary Johnson, the Libertarian, running. And we even got into some Jill Stein. So we're sticking to politics, and right now we have a special surprise. We have our good friend who's been on the show in the past and a fellow activist, somebody that I've worked with Masscare Normal and kept me in the loop. He's kept me in the loop with the Liberty Movement, introduced me to a lot of great people. His name is Frank Capone, and he was a delegate at the Republican National Convention this last week. Is that correct, Frank?
Yes, it is.
Wow. You were in the big center of this huge storm because I posted a bunch of videos from the Republican National Convention dealing with Ron Paul, and my YouTube channel went viral. It was like, I've never seen anything like this. My views went through the roof. My subscribers, I actually making money this week to pay for the show. I'm covering all my production costs this week. You know what I mean? It's just like, it's an amazing story that is unfolding right now because people still don't know what this means. Tell us about your week first and foremost, and let's get into the future of this Ron Paul revolution campaign. A lot of people think it's over, but I don't think it's quite over. Tell us about the week. You were in the center of this huge controversy where the delegates for Ron Paul really got the middle finger. They got stiffed by the Romney folks in the Republican National Convention committee in the convention. Is that correct?
That's absolutely correct. I mean, I got there last Thursday and for the Paul Fest, and immediately started meeting with leaders from all around the country, and we immediately started crafting plans. Some of them had been there a week before for the Rules Committee meetings and the Credentials Committee and all the different challenges and things like that. A little update on the challenge. Massachusetts ended up getting 5 people let back in, 3 alternates and 2 delegates.
Excellent. Was Brad Wyatt one of those?
No, he was not.
Oh, God. He was not. What is up with them? These people, I'm sorry. You know, you got someone who's a real political leader in Massachusetts, Brad Wyatt, and you're not allowing him to serve as a delegate when he was voted in, clearly. I mean, it's just ridiculous. So, all right, that's good to hear some got in, but, you know, as usual.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, there was supposed to be a deal where, you know, we gave up some of our seats so Oklahoma could get some seats. And then in the end, they didn't give any seats to Oklahoma, and we only got 5. So that was the start. You know, that happened the week before the convention, so that set the standard, you know. And then the Rules Committee met, and they doctored and changed all the rules. So basically speaking, no grassroots or activists could ever make it as a delegate ever again, because the presidential campaign would have complete and total oversight, along with the fact that all delegates now to the convention are going to be bound. So it's not like some states are going to be bound and some states aren't going to be bound. Every single last person is going to be bound. And on top of that, they passed a rule that said that they could change the rules at any point in time they wanted, which they tried to sell to me as, oh, well, this is good. That means that every year, you know, you have a chance to rewrite the rules. And it, you know, you don't have to wait 4 years and scramble to try to figure out what the rules should be. You know, and it really, really what highlighted how that was such a lie was the fact that we had collected a plurality of 5 states, which was what was required to get Ron Paul's name put into nomination. And 20 minutes before that vote was set to happen, we had put the nomination papers in, handed them in on time. they changed the rule to make it 8. So wow. All of a sudden, now you need 8 states. Yeah. So whoops, we don't have a plurality anymore. Ron Paul doesn't get into the nomination. So this was a concerted effort. I mean, the day of the Rules Committee, there were 3 buses with important folks. One guy, Morton Blackwell, from Virginia. His bus was redirected and not allowed to enter into the convention center until after the Rules Committee had met and after everything was decided, so they could solidify, you know, their takeover from the grassroots.
This is unbelievable because, you know, in the past we've watched them do this to Ron Paul over and over, and Gary Johnson too. He was running as a Republican, he as well. They were playing games to screw them every step of the way, but now they've taken it to the next level. They're not just screwing these 2 candidates. They're actually screwing the delegates, the people who are actually members of the Republican Party, sometimes long-term members, and not just them, just, you know, other people who are Republican, like non-Ron Paul people.
Exactly.
Are pissed
it's
off.
The Santorum people and the Tea Party people and, you know, the Bachman people and the Palin people and whatever you think about them and whether or not you agree with them or not, that's one thing. But the fact of the matter is it's supposed to be their party too, and everyone should have a voice. You know, it's not supposed to be this top-down thing, because the grassroots people are the people who do all the work. We make the signs, we make the phone calls, we knock the doors. We're the lifeblood of the party, you know, and for them to turn around and slap us in the face like that and then expect us to support them, you know, and work with them, I mean, it's completely ridiculous.
I know.
You know?
So what do you say to them? Because I'm getting this on YouTube all over the place and Facebook from Mitt Romney supporters saying, hey, cut the shit with this. They're just saying to me, stop supporting Gary Johnson. You know you're going to vote for Romney. And I'm telling them, no, I'm not voting for Romney. And you guys gave us no reason. You didn't even try. You did everything. You spat in our faces. And now you want us to vote for Romney.
That's right. Now they want us to vote for Romney. You know, and it's like I had many conversations with many people that were down there, delegates and party people and, you know, people with rank and people without rank. And, you know, whenever you started talking to them about a fair process, they'd always, their first response out of their mouth would be, what do you want, Obama to win? And it's like, I don't know. Is Obama better? Is Romney better? Are they brothers from another mother?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It depends on the issue. I mean, they both suck. But, you know, some issues, Obama might be a little better and some might Romney. That's the way I look at it. I mean, the economy.
Sure, you know, I mean, Romney did balance the budget here in the state, and that's great, you know. I mean, that's something good to be said about him, you know, and, you know, you can say good things about Obama, too.
But it's the same. I mean, it's the same. It's the same operating system on both of these guys. It's top down. Shut up any voices that don't agree with them. Attack. I mean, this is out of control. You guys, the Ron Paul delegates, the activists that you guys brought out. It was impressive. You guys were organized. You guys are active. You're on Facebook. You're part of the, you know, you're really part of a bigger movement that they could have really harnessed into. And it's just ridiculous what they did. Let's talk about going forward. Actually, you know, you were at the convention. Did you get to meet Ron Paul? Did you see Gary Johnson there? Did you have discussion with them?
I met Ron Paul. I met Gary Johnson. I met Rand Paul. I met a bunch of people. I met Van Jones. I met Newt Gingrich.
Van Jones?
Yeah.
Well, what kind of guy was he? Is he he's not working for Obama anymore, right? He's out.
No. Well, I don't know. He was there for CNN. Yeah, he got fired because he signed that 9/11 truth petition from Obama.
Yeah, but I think he's still kind of secretly working for Obama and some back channels.
I mean, yeah, ostensibly, I'm sure they're part of the same organization. Yeah. But he's a good guy. He's a good guy. Regardless, he's a strong organizer. He's done a lot of good work here in Boston, you know. You know, I like the guy. I shook his hand. You know, he was kind of hesitant to shake my hand at first, though. He's like, I'm like, hey, you're Van Jones. And he's like, yeah. And he's like, are you a Glenn Beck supporter? I'm like, no, Glenn Beck's an idiot. He calmed down after that.
That's cool. And he knew you had an open mind.
Yeah, he took an open mind to it. And yes, you know, we talked for a few minutes. I asked Gingrich if he would take me to his moon base. He thought that was pretty funny.
Did you get any photos and video of any of this stuff?
No, I didn't really get any videos or photos. When I met Gingrich, it was like literally like 3:30 in the morning. I was staggering back to my hotel, and he was walking out the door.
Oh yeah, I wonder where he was going.
Yeah,
but
I don't know. I think he was having like meetings. You know, we had all the high level, all Romney's kids, and you know, all the high level people were staying in our hotel because it was within the security perimeter, which was a police state, mind you. I got some pictures of that. I mean, completely ridiculous. Like, where's the boogeyman? Seriously, you know? We've got M16s and AR-15s and 12-foot fences and shoot-to-kill orders for people who jump over the fence, you know, and the Secret Service is there, and all different, you know, military ATF is running around the city, and it's just, it was crazy, you know? And there was maybe like 500 protesters there. There wasn't even any protesters. I think they all got scared away because of the hurricane, you know?
Yeah.
But you have this huge security apparatus that's just like, people are like, I feel so safe in here. And it's like, do you feel safe? Because as far as I can tell, there's a bunch of people with automatic weapons that can lock us in here, right?
I know. I'd be more concerned about the people with the guns than the people out in the street protesting, you know?
Exactly.
Which is the police and the government, you know, with the guns.
Yeah. Yeah, but I actually, one of the funniest things I did witness the whole time I was there was Vermin Supreme debated Gary Johnson. That was probably the highlight of my week.
Oh, we have to look for that. I'm sure that's up on
YouTube. Yeah, it's on YouTube. Oh, man, it's funny. He's debating with both how did you feel about mandatory toothbrushing and all kinds of stuff like
how
that.
How did Gary handle it?
That's the point of, like, moving forward, you know?
Well, no, before we get to that. Yeah. No, wait, listen. Vermin Supreme and Gary Johnson are huge parts of this show. You know, we've had Gary on. Judge Jim Gray, we do Vermin all the time. How did Gary do with Vermin Supreme? I gotta know.
He did really well. He had some funny comebacks to him when he was saying talking about the mandatory toothbrushing, and then with the harnessing the power of zombies for free energy. He was like, I read Gary Johnson said that I read World War Z, and I feel like I'm pretty prepared. Which was pretty funny.
Wow.
And it's definitely up on YouTube.
Oh, I got to check. We will post it and bring it into the show. Definitely, probably for maybe this week or next week. But that's great to hear. So tell me about, like you said, going forward. Did you talk to Gary or Ron Paul or get any information from them? Or just what do you think? Like, what do you think is going to happen from here?
Well, I definitely didn't, you know, get any information from those guys. I talked briefly with some of the people from the campaign for Ron Paul. And, you know, basically the whole idea is that we take this fight back to our states. We take the strong organization that we have created and built up over the last week and a half or so since people have been there. You know, I met people from all over the country, and we're so much more organized than we were 4 years ago that I really have high hopes. I mean, I've been on the phone all day with people. Talking about next steps and where we're going to go and forming, you know, Google groups and, you know, just kind of think tanks and, like something going on right now with Maine, they might possibly strip or void the results of the Maine convention and strip the Ron Paul folks in Maine who won state committee seats and who won national committee seats. Because right now, the youngest woman in the whole entire national committee is a Ron Paul, a lady, and she is from Maine, and because Maine walked out of the convention, and you know, everyone, all the other Ron Paul people walked out with them that was Wednesday, they're all mad at Maine, and so they want to rescind the whole entire convention. Nice. So I mean, there are all sorts of things and backlash that are going to be happening all around the country, both, you know, from the Romney campaign or from the RNC and from our side as well.
What idiots, because this is going to create what the Ron Paul term blowback for Romney and the Republican Party. You know, they've done it to themselves. We put out a video. I actually put out the video where I recorded you and it's kind of pushing you on smoking up a joint at the Republican National Convention. It was a joke, you know. Like, this has happened in the past for Jimmy Carter, for Obama last time, actually, too. you know, at some of these inaugurations and Republican and Democrat national conventions, joints have been smoked on the floor at the events. It's kind of a political protest. And I was curious, you know, with this Ron Paul thing, in a serious way, whether, you know, that kind of culture would show up at this Republican National Convention. And I, you know, for fun, in a joking way, and, you know, a little sensational, but, you know, the fact is we also did a great interview there. We got some real news in there. And that's kind of what we do on this show, is we have fun, but we're serious. And I don't think a lot of people understood, and they got kind of upset, some people. Specifically, we and also on the show, we talked about Carrie Healey, maybe that you would smoke up a joint with Carrie Healey and that we wanted her to come in because she's the former lieutenant governor under Romney. And she was not a delegate, but then she was. And it seemed like you didn't get along with her that well. Or she doesn't like you for some reason. Tell us, did you get to smoke a joint with Carrie Healey? Did you see her? Like, what's the deal on that? Did you get any blowback?
I saw Carrie Healey a few times. Tried to talk to her a few times, but it was very much just kind of a look at me and then like a look away and to you know, back to her handlers, which is what I expected. I mean, you know, it's fun to, you know, have fun and poke fun at you know, at her and about it. But
do you think
she definitely wasn't into getting down and smoking up.
Do you think that she saw the videos or the heard the audio? Do you think some of her people?
I'm sure somebody did, because, you know, I heard from several of the higher-ups in the party, you know, you're lucky that we let you down here, because every other week we get an email from somebody from something you said, or, you know, some show you were on, your show specifically, you know, I think twice, and, you know, they're like, you know, but you have a chance here to you know, get involved, and, you know, a rah-rah, become part of the party speech.
Yeah.
And it's like, I mean, sure, that's great, but I mean, how can I justify becoming part of their party, you know, when this is the way that they treat the grassroots people? I mean, we registered, what, 2,000 people to the Republican Party in this state during the caucus process? And what thanks do we have for that? I hope they realize that those people probably aren't going to stay Republicans, you know, especially after the way that they see that we've been treated, you know, for all of our hard work and our dedication.
And the Republican Party is a big-time minority party in Massachusetts. It's not even close.
11%.
Yeah, they need everybody they can get. You bring 2,000 people in, that's a lot in the state, when most voters in Massachusetts aren't even Democrats, they're unenrolled. More people are unenrolled than Democrats. Democrats are the number two party, really. But Republicans are like, you know, way down there. I think the Libertarians might pass them eventually here in Massachusetts, you know, in the Green Party, seriously, with Jill Stein here. But, you know, like, so they definitely, a lot of these people saw the video. Do you think they got it? Like, do you think that they understood where we were coming from? Or do you think they were all just like, oh, man, those guys are wild child? I'm just wondering.
Yeah, they didn't understand at all where we were coming from. They don't understand where we're coming from, because to them, any form of dissension or anything that, you know, deviates from their storyline is considered, you know, completely dangerous, you know, to their message and their chances. I mean, they're right now dancing within the 3% margin with a, you know, a victory. So, I mean, if it sways one way or the other, then you know, that they're not going
to
win.
No free thinking off the script allowed. You have to be 100% on the script. You read from the script, and that's all.
Well, yeah, and John Boehner understands that. I mean, I don't know if you watched it, but when they had the vote on the rules, there was clearly division in the crowd with the yeas and the nays, but on the teleprompter, it said, the ayes have it.
Yeah.
And so that's what John Boehner read, and boom, gavel down. Texas yelled point of order for 10 minutes.
Yeah.
And you know what the people in there chanted over Texas?
USA!
USA!
Yeah.
USA! USA! Okay, while we are there, while people from Texas, while the whole entire Texas delegation, people are Ron Paul people are Romney people, are standing up there demanding a point of order, completely ignored. You know, and that was the tone of the convention. You
That's
know,
just,
shut up, get in line, and keep him up. You know, just get in line.
I mean, I did see that. The guy is supposed to be presiding over a meeting with a vote. Right? If anyone's ever done that, I've done these at MassCan normal meetings. I've been to plenty of hearings at city councils and all the rest of it. You don't read from a script when you're chairing a committee meeting. You find out what's going. You know, you're running a meeting and you don't know if it's going to go yes or no. So how can you read from a script? And that's what
exactly.
It was.
The chair
was reading,
is supposed to be impartial.
The script was there. People videotaped the script scrolling across the screen. It's on YouTube.
Sure.
Look it up. That's just so shocking that it basically, and how dumb they are, because they're basically saying John Boehner, whatever you want to call him, he's nothing but an actor. He's reading a script. He's just like Johnny Depp, except Johnny Depp's got more talent. You know what I mean? I mean, it's a joke. It's
Even his when his speech, he equated it to a bar fight. He was like, you throw him out of the bar if he's saying the economy's good when your buddy lost his job. It's ridiculous. It's completely banal bullshit.
It's all script. The whole thing was a Republican Hollywood convention. That's what it was.
Exactly what it was. And I mean, they'll tell you that too. You know, if you get them, if you talk to them, you know, because the days, according to them, of old timey primary conventions, rather, where you know there was a fight going in, that doesn't happen anymore because you know it's very much made for TV, for the TV cameras to sell their candidate to the general public. And to set the message, and you know that's all well and good, but they should get they should not allow any kind of process. They should do it today. They should, all right, we're gonna have a 1-day party, and boom, we're gonna nominate this person, and that's gonna be it.
That's lame.
They want to drag it out, and they want to play. They want to have this parliamentary theater where you know it's like, oh yeah, well you can have all of these remedies, but you don't actually have any of them. Ha 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 ha. You know.
Yeah, it's a joke. A joke.
It is a joke. It's a sick joke.
So, going forward, the question I put to our audience today was Tuesday night, September 4th, Ron Paul is a scheduled guest on the Jay Leno show. There's a lot of speculation on that Ron Paul is going to have some special news to announce. Matt Larson on his YouTube's gone viral too in the last couple weeks. I mean, this whole Ron Paul thing again. Has really helped a lot of us. My YouTube channel, I'm gaining subscribers every day. So I want to thank Mitt Romney and the Kerry Hillies of this world because they're bringing people our way. And I really appreciate all of the unintended blowback that they help us with. But, basically Ron Paul is going to be on the Jay Leno show this week. And Matt Larson has said on YouTube, he wonders if Ron Paul might actually take the libertarian position from Gary Johnson. Gary Johnson would step aside, become the vice president. Matt, is in the same place as myself. We don't even know if this is possible. We don't know if Gary Johnson would consider it. We don't know if the Libertarian Party would allow it with the rules and how things are done. There's only 2 months to go. It's 2 months and a week, so it's 9 weeks to the election. I don't see it happening. I don't think that Gary Johnson's going to step aside, number one. I don't think, number two, it's possible. So I have a question.
I think that Gary Johnson would step aside. I can't remember exactly where I had heard it, but I was pretty sure I had heard something to the effect where, you know, Gary Johnson had said that he'd be more than happy to, you know, be vice president if Ron Paul decided to go that way.
Yeah, but
and I don't know if he's going to go that way. You know?
Yeah, I think the context of that, though, was if Ron Paul won the Republican nomination. And Gary was running as a libertarian. I believe that was the context of that. So, you know, these things change as we go. You know, like, I think Gary Johnson's going to be committed to the Libertarian Party because he took their nomination. People voted for him. So once you take, you know, it's almost like you got voted into office in a way. You know, it's kind of hard to go back on that unless the libertarians vote. You know, maybe that's what they're going to do. Maybe they're going to send a mailing to every libertarian, and the libertarians could decide to do this. You know, that would be a special thing, but I just think that's going to be tough to do in 9 weeks.
I would like to see Paul and Huntsman team up.
Yeah. I don't think they can't, though. That's the thing, what I'm saying. 9 weeks, you can't get on the ballot in 9 weeks. 50 states?
No, you can't, but can he get on the Americans Elect thing?
What's that?
The Americans Elect was that supposed to be the first online convention where you could vote candidates up and down. I'm not sure if Gary Johnson won it or if Ron Paul won it. But they got on the ballot in all 50 states.
Oh, really? So maybe there are some other parties who've done it secretly, and we don't know. Like, I'd never heard of them. That's interesting.
Yeah, actually, it was put together by a bunch of Wall Street guys, which is interesting. And a lot of people had speculated that because there were some people who were actual delegates, you know, for Romney or, you know, for Santorum or something like that, who had signed on, because when you sign on to it, you had to give your name and all your information, and it showed up, you know, you were a delegate for, you picked Ron Paul for Ron Paul. And so that would give them grounds to bounce you because you had pledged to a candidate, you know, from a different party or whatever.
Oh, so they were using that against you, the RNC. Very interesting.
Yeah, they used it against some of the people, yeah.
That's crazy. So there could be a possibility of another party that we aren't even aware of that may be in waiting for Ron Paul. That's very interesting.
I mean, he could just run as an independent. He doesn't have to be on any party.
No, he doesn't. He could go run as a write-in, but Willie, you know, and I don't think Ron Paul's going to do anything like that unless he knows he can get on 50 state ballots. That's my opinion. I think Ron Paul's a very serious individual. He's at an age, why is he going to waste his time? He's been through all this over the last, 5 years he's been running for president. I think the more likely news on Tuesday night is that Ron Paul is going to endorse Gary Johnson, and that Ron Paul is going to campaign for Gary Johnson, speak for him, travel across the country and campaign for him, and maybe announce that he's going to be the Treasury Secretary in the Gary Johnson administration, you know, basically running the federal, you know, being the boss to the Federal Reserve in some respects, telling them what to do. Wouldn't that be friggin' awesome? Like, why can't that happen? Do you think that there's a chance of that happening? What do you think, Frank?
I think there is a chance of that happening. I mean, but I wonder, because of the position that Rand Paul is in. You know, Rand Paul right now is trying to play good cop, and then he's trying to become part of the party and, you know, not make too many waves and things like that. And I really think that there would be a significant amount of blowback against Rand if his dad, you know, was to do anything. I don't know if you...
You know what, though? I think that this is where we've all kind of missed the boat. I'm glad you brought that up. You brought up so many interesting points today. You know, like, that is a good point, because I wasn't really thinking that. But think back, like, when people got mad at Rand Paul because he basically endorsed Romney. And like you said, he went to the center. And people got mad. They felt like he betrayed Ron Paul. Well, this sets it up perfect for Ron Paul, because it's now been established that Rand and Ron Paul, father and son, are not the same people. And I think that they love each other and respect each other enough that they could actually, that Ron Paul could endorse Gary Johnson, and Rand Paul could stay as a Republican and endorse Mitt Romney, and they both will just deal with the fallout and remain stronger, because they're their own people, and they still respect each other. I think that actually is a possibility. Think about that, you know, because it's already been established that they're their own person, you know, when Rand did that.
Yeah, I mean that could be a possibility. I just from what I've seen, you know, being down there and what I know from, you know, knowing people that work fairly closely with their campaigns, I don't really see the possibility of that. I mean, the best thing I can hope for with Ron Paul going on Jay Leno is to just really hammer the RNC and really you know, drive home the reality of what we faced and the kind of things that we dealt with as delegates to the RNC, trying to take part in the process, trying to follow their arbitrary rules as they made them up, you know. And I hope that's kind of what he does, because, I mean, honestly, we need to stay in the news cycle about this. We can't just let it go, because the DNC is coming up this week. And so unless we keep this in the news, unless we can relate it somehow to things going on at the DNC or things that are pertinent in that, you know, in that way, we're going to lose our momentum and people are going to forget about it. It's the whole idea that, you know, you take a hit now in order for it to, you know, just die down later as we get closer to the general.
Wow. You know, one last question before we let you go here is, do you plan to continue to be a Republican, and will you vote for Mitt Romney at this point?
I'm going to vote my conscience, man. I mean, I don't know. You know,
still haven't made up your mind?
I still haven't made up my mind.
I think we're all
there. But when I do, I'll pull the trigger. You know, and vote for who I think is the best person to vote for. As far as what I'm going to do, am I going to stay a Republican? There's no sense in changing my registration at this point. And I'm going to see how it goes. You know, I think we have a poised to really take over the party in this state. I mean, especially due to the fact of the such low registration and our ability to organize and energize and get people involved in politics that have never been involved before, that have never thought about being involved. So to have that kind of a party apparatus and structure, have that kind of party apparatus and structure there already is a good, better thing than trying to build it all on your own. So
absolutely.
That's still up in the air at this point, but for now, yes.
Yep. I mean, there's that old saying, you know, I'm against the major parties, the Democrats and the Republicans. I'm telling people to vote for third party. But at certain points, strategy-wise, I always think I should join them. You know, it's like, if you can't beat them, join them. And I always wonder, if should I be a Democrat or Republican? Because, you know, that there is a way to get things done. And that is one of the ways, and I'm glad that you're doing the work, Frank, and I may even join you as a Republican because I want to work with you. I want to be involved in what you're doing. It's not about Mitt Romney or the Republican Party for me, but it's about working with good people, and you are definitely one of them, and I want to thank you so much for calling in today and giving us all this info.
I appreciate it, brother, and you are as well. Keep up the good work.
You too. Keep us informed. Anything going on with the Republican Party, Ron Paul, anytime you guys need people out, you know who to call. We always want to get the word out on the activism you're doing.
Absolutely. We're going to have a lot of news coming up. We've got organizational meetings happening all the time. We're going to be rolling out a state organization here pretty soon, and I'll keep you guys up to date. And, again, thanks a lot for having me on.
Excellent. Is there any way that people should look for you for info, just Frank Capone on Facebook, or is there any websites, or is that just upcoming and we'll announce it later?
The best place to go right now is MA, so like the abbreviation of Massachusetts.
Say that again?
Liberty.
Okay.
MA, Liberty Caucus. .org.
Oh, perfect. Liberty, yep. MA, like Mass, yep. MA, Liberty, yep. Caucus.org. Perfect.
Yep.
All right, we'll check that out. We'll post it up. And again, thank you for spending time. I know you got a family and it's a Saturday. Definitely appreciate it, Frank Capone. You're the man.
I appreciate it too, man. Take care. Thank you.
All right, that was Frank Capone, Republican National Delegate. This last week's big convention, you heard what was going on. You saw it on YouTube. He was there. He was among it. He met them all. He met Newt Gingrich. He met Ron Paul, Gary Johnson. Sounds like an amazing but somewhat frustrating week. But, hey, you know, he met all these new people, and they're organizing, and they're not going to be able to stop the growth of what we're doing here, which is we want freedom. We want freedom. We want justice, social justice. We want change. You know, we're sick of the establishment and the Fortune 500 and the banks, Goldman Sachs running this country. Folks like John Corzine, who gave a bunch of money to Obama, steals farms from family farmers, steals their money, and he's not in jail, and probably won't go to jail because he's connected. But if you know any of us, we can't pay our tax bill, they're going to take your paycheck. They're going to throw you in jail. You know. Things are just out of whack. We all know it. We're all feeling it in this recession with the job situation. We need change, and I'm so glad that Frank, we're able to talk to him today about all the news that's been going on nationally. Our phone number is 617-606-4122 if you want to call in. Also, I think we got another call. Is that Ron Paul on the phone?
Yeah.
This is Congressman Ron Paul?
How you doing, guys?
No, this isn't Ron Paul. Who is this?
That's the problem with phones. Every time you make a phone call, you lose 10 phone calls. It's blowback.
Oh, my God. You were listening? Were you listening to us, Ron? Listening to the show?
I was listening to America.
Wow. And what is going to be the special news on Tuesday, Ron?
We just got to leave other countries alone.
This isn't Ron Paul. Wow. Thank you for calling so much, Congressman Ron Paul.
Have a nice day.
You're listening on regular radio, Two Hotheads, where activism happens. Phone number 617-606-4122. I'm Mike Cann. We just did a long interview with Frank Capone, a special secret. We didn't even know we were going to do that interview, and that was great. We got a lot of news and broke some news, I think, you know, some things that I didn't even know about. So very, very, you know, good little segment. We're going to come back. We're going to talk to Casey Hoy from Unregular Radio in a few minutes. And we're going to play some music in between. But if you want to call up, if you're maybe Gary Johnson's listening, 617-606-4122, you can give us a call and let us know what you thought about the Republican National Convention, what you think about Gary Johnson right now, Jill Stein, Vermin Supreme, any of these candidates. Give us a call and let us know what's up. Also, a lot of stuff going on with medical marijuana legalization. We got a ballot initiative here in Massachusetts, the Freedom Rally. So many things going on. So you can, if you want to comment on any of those things, you know the things that we'd like to cover. Give us a ring. That's what we want to hear. 617-606-4122. You can also send us instant feedback at if@unregularradio.com. We also have a couple of folks sitting in. We're going to ask their opinion on what's been going on in these campaigns and what they hope will happen or maybe think will happen. We'll come back with some after some music and get more into it. But what we got a lot of good music today. What do we have upcoming, Derek Frary?
Dead Prez with Politrix.
Oh, I meant Ron Paul.
Oh, we got a little bit of Dead Prez.
I love when he does that. Ron Paul.
Politrix, that's all it is.
Ron Paul in the studio. 617-606-4122 if you want to talk to Ron Paul. Here's the Dead Prez.